Ever since you've been in kindergarten, you've been learning about some arithmetic operations. Which is the one that put two amounts together?
Addition.
Which is the one that we take it away?
Subtraction.
My goodness, you are using all those second grade words now. Addition, subtraction.
Multiplication.
We have also learned the shortcut for addition.
Multiplication.
And now we are learning the shortcut for subtraction, which is
division.
Okay. I just need to write it in case you want to know how to spell the word division, because it sounds shun, but are you going to see the SH?
No.
No, we don't see the
I-O-N.
Division. And the symbol.
It's because it's like robot. When I was in Mr. Commotion.
Commotion, that's right. Same shun, same ending. Division. What is the key word for division? The key word for division.
Equal.
What does it mean? Equal, okay, equal, but equal what?
Equal.
What do we do?
Take away equal set.
We have an amount.
Share
a set of something equally.
Like take away equal set.
Take away equal set. Same thing. Okay, let's pretend. Here we have a group of, in this case, there are magnets. Can this be cookies?
No.
Yeah. Yes, yes. Could this be marbles?
Yeah.
Yes. Could this be little Cheerios?
Yeah.
Sure, why not? Could this be
grapes?
We can still eat them at the end after they have been shared equally, right? Or unless we have some leftovers also. They could still
be
grapes
and
grapes.
Or grapes. Okay. Help me count all these, and I don't want to count by ones. So help me count by twos.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10. For now, I'm going to use just 12. And since I'm working with numbers, I need to double check that I have the number that I need to work with. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Pretend that these are 12 cars. Okay? Pretend there are 12 cars. Those 12 cars need to be parked into three garages. So they need to be parked into three different garages. Okay? So do you think I'm gonna spend my time drawing pretty garages here?
No.
I can use squares or circles. Yeah, would that work?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
so let's do. Those are my garages. And this one I'm going to call it garage A. This one I'm going to call it garage B. And this one garage C. And here are all my cars. Oops, I forgot to close. Okay, are you with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, not everybody. Are you with me? Got it. Okay. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. I have my 12 garages here. And they need to be divided equally into those three garages. Those are cars that need to go into those garages. So, if you can draw this on paper, it will be in like, you can start counting. But since we can move these cars, let's do it like this. I want to hear you say this one. Remember we practiced like this the other day? This one goes in garage A. Okay, so say it with me. This one goes in garage A. This one goes in garage B. This one goes in garage C. This one goes in garage A. This one goes in garage B. This one goes in the garage C. This one goes in the garage A. This one goes to the garage B. This one goes to garage C.
This one goes to garage A. This one goes to garage B. This one goes to garage C.
And the end.
No. Not yet, not yet. Do we have any more cars left over?
No.
No, because they are all going to those garages and they're all parked nicely. Okay, so now, what number did we, how many cars did we start with?
12.
12. No, I'm gonna be using now the division, the number sentence. 12 divided by how many garages? Three equals four. Now here we go. Remember? I'm gonna ask, let me see. We've been doing this and I think we need to practice again. Let me ask, I'll be A and you'll be B. You can help yourself, yep, by looking it up there. And we have the question, what does this mean? Look what it says here. It means, and there's a number here, right? A number will go here and a number will go here. Let's practice. Let me start. Let me get you started. What does this mean?
This means.
Oh, you said this. Take a look.
This.
It says this. Can we use the word this?
Yeah, or it.
Can we use the word it?
Yes.
It? It means. Will it be the same?
It means.
Let's practice with it. Let's practice with it. Ready? Go. It means.
12 divided by 3.
Equals 4. Let's try. Let me see. I will show you. We can always use the word this. Okay? This means 12 divided by 3 equals 4. Vanessa is asking me about this word over here. It says equals. We can also use another word for equals. Is. Okay? So if you use the word is, which is not a verb, or the word equals, it means pretty much the same. It will still make sense. Okay? Now, okay, let's try this one. What is the big number we're going to start with?
13.
Let's count again. Count. 2.
4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14.
14?
15.
Okay. It's not even. But let's see what we can do with the number 15. Let's see, this could be 5 jelly beans. My mom came from the store and she brought jelly beans. And she said, look what I got for you. Jelly beans, I got, 15. Cool. Well, mama, I'm gonna go outside and play with my friends. Sure, just don't eat all the jelly beans to yourself. Promise, I won't, even though I feel like eating them up. I said, nope, I'm gonna go outside. And when I went outside, I found my friends. And they said, okay, hi, Sonia, say hi. Would you like to play? Say, sure. Look what I have. I have some jelly beans that I would like to share with you. You know how many friends I had?
One wasn't your best friend anymore.
Oh, that was one, yeah, long time ago. There were 4 of us altogether, 3 friends and myself. So that means that now I have to divide these 15 jelly beans into 4 people. 2? No, my 3. This is me, 1 for me, and my 3, my other friends. I need to make this a little bit bigger to make them fit. 1, 2, 3. Okay. B for Billy. R for Rudy. S. Okay. J for Justin. Okay. Ready? Here we go. 1 for Billy, 1 for Rudy, 1 for Justin, 1 for
me, 1 for Billy, 1 for Rudy, 1 for Justin, 1 for me, 1 for Billy, 1 for Rudy,
1 for Justin, 1 for me. Do I still have enough?
Yes.
Look at this. How many do I have? 3. How many does Billy have? 3. How many does Rudy have? 3. How many does Justin have? 3. Look at what I have here. If I give 1 to me, 1 to Billy, and 1 to Justin, have they been divided equally? What would Rudy say? What about me? It's not
fair.
So, Leftovers. I will just have to keep these and take them back. So give me your numbers, number sentence. Turn to your partner. What would be the number sentence for division? That's true. Good idea. I could do that. Turn to your partner. What would be the number sentence? What would be the number sentence? What number did I start at the beginning? 15.
Divided by 4 equals
3. With the remainder of? Over 3. You got it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, here we go. Listen carefully. Boys.
Yeah.
Listen. Boys. You're going to be A. Girls, yeah. You'll be B. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, boys, we're ask A. The question.
What does this mean?
Girls.
This means.
This means divide by 3.
With a remainder of 3.
Reminder.
Reminder. Oh, remainder. What other word can we use for remainder?
Reminder.
Mm. Leftover.
Leftover with a leftover of 3. Okay.
Can you go to the house?